And this is the second material called hinges to mount the doors. The hinges to mount the doors is 1842. All these materials imported from England. So all these materials imported from England, not the one that we made in Nigeria, but the one imported from England. Now, this is another material. This is called the iron corrugated sheet. The ones on the roof, sensitive, you can see the iron corrugated sheet, still on the roof, sensitive 42. You can see that we can compare it to this one. This is the made in Nigeria today, but this is the one imported from England. But look at this one. You can see that we can compare the two together. Easily try to paint this one, but not easily. But we can try to paint this. You can see. So we can compare the two exteriors to the inside of the building. We have how many rooms inside of this building? 6 rooms inside of this building. And we also have the Agiatu. So the name of the tree called what? Agiatu. But the name of the two missionary reverend, Christian under the tree, called Reverend Thomas Brash Freeman. Reverend Thomas what? Brash Freeman. The primary school. They spent how many years in primary school? 12 years in primary school. So this is the room for the teacher. And this is a man called the first teacher in Nigeria, called Mr. Claudius Philip. Established the first primary school in Madagi and the whole of Nigeria. Name of the school called St. Thomas Primary School. Established in 1845 with 40 men. So the 40 men spending 12 years in primary school. Now we're going upstairs and to see the room of a man called Bishop Samuel Ajayi Crowder, and that's the man that translated the English Bible into what? The Yoruba Bible. And this way. He is saying local government. He is saying what? Local government. And this man called Ajayi, born in 1809. Ajayi was born in 1809. But in 1821, this man, it was captured as a slave by Fulani town in Sierra Leone. It was sold to a free town in Sierra Leone. So when this man got to free town in Sierra Leone, he worked with a missionary in Sierra Leone. But the name of his master, who bought him as a slave, called Crowder in Sierra Leone. Unfortunately, this man returned back to Nigeria as interpreter. He returned back to Nigeria as what? Interpreter. The first word, King James Version. But this is the Yoruba Bible, the one Ajayi Crowder wrote. But look at this picture of this young man, Ajayi Crowder. The same man stands here and that building painting a yellow there. Look at that building painting the yellow there. And that's the residence house. The residence house of a man called Sir Frederick Lord Lugard. And that is the one, that's the house they did amalgamation of Nigeria in 1914. That building painting the yellow there. And that's the house of the first governor general in Nigeria. The house of the first what? Governor general in Nigeria. So that's the man that did what? Did the amalgamation of Nigeria in 1914. First Christmas. And that's the man called Thomas Brash Freeman. Thomas what? Brash Freeman. Now the second missionary reverend also preached under the tree called Reverend Henry Townsend. Reverend what? Henry Townsend. Reverend Henry Townsend is happened to be what? The first church in Nigeria. But this is the man building this house. A man that built this story building, this house. This is the man called Reverend C.A. Goma. Reverend C.A. what?
Goma.
Building this house in 1845. The first CMS parsonage. The first what? CMS parsonage. We all know the meaning of CMS. That's the Christian Missionary Society. This is the man building, and it's 100 years old chair. 100 years old chair, 1915 chair. And this is the safe, the first saving bank. Introduce what? Trade by barter. They introduce what? Trade by barter. So we all know the meaning of the trade by barter. Exchange of goods to what? To goods. Now the white men coming to Africa have to come here with the things like a gun. They have to come here with the things like clothes, mirror, umbrella, packet of matches, spoon, dry gin for exchange of human being. Then a bottle of dry gin, exchanging of 10 able human beings. Bottle of dry gin, exchange of how many slaves? 10 able human beings. and a packet of matches, exchange of 5 able human beings. A 1 packet of matches, exchange of 5 able human beings. And a spoon, exchange of 3 able human beings. A spoon, exchange for how many slaves? 3 able human beings. A umbrella, exchange of 40 able human beings. 1 umbrella, exchange of how many slaves? 40 able human beings. And a gun, the one the hunters use, exchange of 45 slaves. And this, and a mirror, exchange of 35 slaves. 1 mirror, exchange of how many slaves? 35 slaves. And these are the things the white men use for exchange of human being in Africa. So slave trade finally stopped in Badagry in 1886. And slave trade lasted in Badagry for 400 years. Slave trade lasted in Badagry for how many years? 400 years. So after the abolition of the slave trade, now we have been colonized by the British. Now the British government introduced this money to us. This is the first coins introduced by the British. And this money called farthing. This is the money called what? Farthing. And this money called farthing. So 10 of farthing equivalent to 1 penny. 10 of a farthing equivalent to how many penny? The 1 penny. So after the farthing, I will say the money called the 1 penny. 1 what? 1 penny. This is the money called the 1 penny. After a 1 penny, I will say the money called the 1 shilling. This is the money called the 1 shilling. 1 what? 1 shilling. So after the 1 shillings, I will say the money called the 5 pence. And this is the money called the 5 what? Pence. This is the money called the 5 pence. After the 5 pence, I will say the money called the 6 pence. This is the money called 6 pence. This money called what? 6 pence. But in 1973, the Federal Republic of Nigeria, the Federal what? Republic of Nigeria changed to the money called Naira and Kobo. Naira what? And Kobo. In 1973. In 1973, we changed to the money, our home money, called what? Naira and Kobo. And now this is the money called the 1 Kobo. Changed in 1973. That's the 1 Kobo. The first coins that we first spent in Nigeria. Not the one that we're talking about. We're talking about the British money. But this is the one, our home, that we spend in this country, called one kobo. And now, after the one kobo, we send the money called the half kobo. This is the money called what? Half kobo. This is the money called the half kobo. After the half kobo, and we also send the money called the 5 kobo. And this is the money called the 5 kobo and 10 kobo. 5 and 10 kobo. This is the 5 kobo and 10 kobo. The 5 kobo and 10 kobo. So after the 5 kobo and 10 kobo, and we say the money called the 50 kobo and 1 naira. The 50 kobo and 1 naira. 50 kobo and 1 naira. This is the olden days money that we spent in this country. So thank you very much for coming to first story building in Nigeria. Built in 1845 by the missionary and being managed by the Anglican Church. The Anglican Church being in control of this building. So it was being taken care of the Anglican Church. So managing this building. Thank you very much. Please go away now.
He said you watch us. Yeah.